Hello and welcome. I'm Peggy. And oh, I do enjoy visiting with people. That, you know, that's the nicest part of being on the Peggy Denny Show, is the people you get to meet and the inspiration that they bring. And we have some inspiration to share with you today. And I'm so pleased to have two people here from the Greenville Family Partnership. And if you don't know about it, they do a great work. And I'm so pleased to have two people here that I had not met before. Emily Harper is here. Now, Emily is the Prevention Education Coordinator. And next to her is Corin Hewins. And Corin is the Youth Prevention, right? So I'm so pleased to have you. And you have things going on all the time.
Yes, ma'am.
And a special outreach to young people.
Yes, yeah. Greenville Family Partnership is a prevention organization, and two of our focuses are parents, and then we also focus on the youth. So with parenting classes, we have those year-round where parents can come and just learn more on, you know, how to be a great parent. And then the youth programs, we do programs in the schools all year, and then in the summer we really focus on a lot of summer camps and just getting in there and keeping them involved during the summertime.
So now you have parenting classes, mm-hmm, for people to learn more about, because it's the hardest job in the world.
Yes, right. It is.
To be a good parent is a full-time job.
Right, that's correct.
And then you have other programs, mm-hmm, for other age groups and especially things for young people.
Yes, definitely.
And they go on all the time.
Oh,
and and of course we will have a phone number and some information for you, and anybody can come to these things that the Family Partnership has.
Yeah.
Do they have to join or what?
Well, typically if we do a summer camp, they send us a program request sheet form, and what that consists of is if the camp say they want a topic of like bullying, they would send us the program request sheet form and we would send it back that we confirmed and got it, and we would plan a lesson based on what they sent us. And so we go out to the camp, we go into the community to do the lesson that we've produced.
That's powerful. So you go into all year long.
Yes.
But in summer camps, you would go to the camps and then you also go into the classrooms of various schools.
Yes, sometimes we can do Greenville County Schools, depending on the schedule, because already Greenville County School is already tight-knit. But sometimes we do a lot of after-school programs.
Okay.
So that way we can still get to the students even in the school year.
Well, I know firsthand that you people make a difference in a lot of lives. And you have this Youth Summit coming up. Now, I want people to know about this. And what is it, and who can go, and just fill us in on all the details.
Yeah, well, our Youth Summit is a two-day workshop, July 28th and 29th. Bob Jones has graciously let us use their facility for 2 days.
Oh my.
It's free food. You get breakfast and lunch.
Breakfast and lunch, and of course, they have good parking there.
Right, right. Mm-hmm. So, you know, you'll be able to walk. The campus is beautiful. If you haven't seen Bob Jones, it's amazing. And so pretty much what we do is we get a group of kids ages 14 to 17, and they come in and we talk about real issues in Greenville County. A lot of kids aren't aware of the issues that go on right under our noses. And not only do we talk about the problems and issues in Greenville County, but we also come up with solutions so that this generation, we can be the generation to change and have a positive outlook.
Well, you know, I have a feeling that not only do the kids not know, I think a lot of us don't know what's going on.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, I agree.
It's happening right here under our noses, and we're just kind of unaware of it.
Yeah, and I really like the Youth Summit because we get a lot of diversity, and I think that's a great thing for youth to know about. Like, sometimes we are so caught up in our own circle, and that it's good to be able to see the other side and for the other side to see, you know, the other person. And that's how, that's how you become a better person.
So now this is coming up July 28th and 29th.
Yes, ma'am.
But is it just for the young people? What age groups, or can anybody go?
Well, the age group that we try to target for is 14 to 17 years old. Okay. We want people who are like kind of fresh in high school, okay, not yet out of school, public school, and not yet going to college, because we really want to get that generation and target those kids so they will be able to lead and be a great leader before they go on to the next level.
This is wonderful, and it's wonderful that Bob Jones has given you that facility to use.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Mm-hmm. And it's easy to find, and parking, and, you know, it's a good avenue for you to have.
Yeah, and the students are there from 9 to 3, so it's an all-day, pretty much all-day event, but we're full, it's plenty of activities. I mean, they won't be bored. At first, you get kind of, you know, shaky. You're meeting new people that you don't know, but little do they know, it's building a better foundation for when they move to the next step.
Are you going
to
have speakers, guest speakers, or what?
Well, we go for, Greenville Family Partnership has their interns and people who have already attended the Youth Summit. Some of them are facilitators.
Okay.
Emily and myself are both facilitators for the Youth Summit. So we kind of actually form the Youth Summit. We do the lesson plan and we bring it out to the students. And so we have previous people come back and kind of do special activities, and we show inspirational videos, and it's a great 2 days. I enjoy it.
It's a wonderful learning experience.
Yes.
for people that age, and they share and they meet other young people.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yes, they definitely. It's a great networking opportunity for them. And again, like Corin said, we want it to be a very diverse group, so it's great, you know, for two people that may not normally interact, and they can talk about these issues together and learn about those issues and learn how to solve some of these problems in Greenville County.
Well, Greenville, tell me, what, I know Greenville Family Partnership is doing this summer.
Yes.
And what other things do they do?
Well, we have 40 summer camps scheduled so far, and we're hoping to get
more.
Wow,
40 summer camps.
Yes.
Oh, crazy. No wonder you're smiling.
Yeah, and that will hopefully reach about 2,000 youth, ages 5 up into high school. So it's a great variety of kids and a great variety of topics. We talk about tobacco, marijuana, alcohol, bullying, cyberbullying is a big one, especially for middle school and high school students. And so it's just even things down to communication skills and anger management, just normal life skills that some of these children may not experience normally.
Yeah, that's fabulous.
Thank you.
It is. And these kids don't have to pay to come to this.
No, this completely free. We don't charge the camps for us to go out there. And I think that's one of the biggest things for Greenville Family Partnership is that we try to do things as low cost as possible so that people don't have to pay us to come out there. We come out there for free, and we're all passionate about what we do. So
now, what if a young person comes to those 2 days, mm-hmm, what actually would they, what they be able to do?
Well, when you go, we enter in, we have like kind of like icebreakers and warm-ups, so we can get them kind of loose, because it is early, and it's a summertime, so kids are ready to sleep in. And so then we kind of get them loose and to let them know what the Youth Summit is about and what you can gain. Me personally, I attended the Youth Summit before I became a facilitator. So at first for me, I was very nervous. I didn't know anyone. And I left with a whole new outlook on myself and also Greenville County. I met some lifelong friends that, you know, I still talk to this day. You do a lot of self-finding. And what you may not know that you like to do, but or you find something that someone else has in common with you. So, like, you kind of make connections that really last you a lifetime. And it's great for even college. Like, this is a great way to put on your college, you know, applications that I attended this summit. And, you know, I've learned so many diverse things and so many issues in my county alone.
So you'd want to include that in a resume.
Yeah, it would be great for a resume.
For a school or a job or anything, I would think.
Right. It'll be great for a resume to write it down. You learn a lot of skills that are like lifelong skills.
Okay, now if somebody wants more information, we do have a phone number, which we can put up, I think we have it, and put it up and leave it up. And it's 467-4099. Of course, yes. That's 864. Mm-hmm. Now, so you do not charge to come to this?
No, ma'am. It's completely free. So everyone, especially if you're between the ages of 14 and 17, free is like a magic word. So, and free and food. So you get both the best of both worlds. And we also, if you attend both days, which we recommend you do, we have giveaways. We have prizes the last day.
Giveaways?
Yes, the giveaways. Mm-hmm. We get a lot of little gift cards from different variety of places in Greenville County. And they really like to support us because we're doing, you know, a good cause for the youth.
Yeah, that was my next question. This takes a lot of doing to put something like this together.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So you've had support from businesses and business leaders?
Yes. Well, we're working on that right now, but we're going to have a lot of great prizes, like Corin said, hopefully a lot of gift cards, and we're also going to have some free T-shirts. So it'll be really great for some of these kids, you know, especially the ones who are very involved. It'll be a great reward for them.
Well, what actually, if a young person comes to this event, mm-hmm. and they just kind of come in cold, you know, right. what will they accomplish?
Well, our theme, I forgot to tell you our theme. Our theme this year is form your own lane, take your own exit. That's our theme. And pretty much what that means is we want the students that come in to know that it's okay to be in your own lane. You don't have to follow the crowd, especially
good
if a crowd
you.
Is doing something that you may not be comfortable with doing. So in this youth summit, someone who's coming in brand new, we hope and our prayer is that when they come out, they understand that it's okay if I'm in my own lane and I do what makes me happy and I don't necessarily follow the crowd that's going a negative way.
That's a great message. And many times young people at that age, they're insecure, they want to belong, and sometimes they're led to do something that maybe they don't feel comfortable with because they're afraid to step back and say no.
Right, I totally agree. I think that age group is very difficult growing up because you have so many things that are coming at you and you necessarily might not know which way to go. But the Youth Summit is definitely a great place to start in finding your own lane and taking your own exit.
And I'm sure that this is well planned and well thought out and done very professionally.
Yes.
And I know that they would not have given you the privilege of using their facility if they didn't know ahead of time that this was going to be a powerful thing.
Right. We've been doing the Youth Summit. This is our ninth year. So Bob Jones is great in letting us use their facility and providing us with a lot of, you know, great hospitality.
Okay. Well, we're going to find out more in a minute, so stay with us. We're going to back a quick break, and we'll be right back.